Hospital, College of Nursing, Coimbatore in 2001. Ma'am had completed her MPhil from Mother Teresa University in 2006. Currently, she is doing her PhD in nursing from Yenapoya University. Ma'am had worked as a staff nurse in CMC Vellur for 1 year and worked as a clinical instructor in School of Nursing, Sadar Memorial Hospital, Ranipet for 2 years and worked as a nursing tutor in School of Nursing, St. Philomena's Hospital, Bangalore for 2 years. Also, ma'am had worked as a principal in St. Mary's School of Nursing, Tenkashi for 4 years and she had worked as assistant lecturer, assistant professor and coordinator principal in Cherans College of Nursing, Coimbatore from 1998 to 2008. Currently, she is working as a principal in Tech City College of Nursing, Coimbatore. We rarely get this kind of opportunity to listen to the words of a great knowledgeable speaker. I welcome you, ma'am.
Geriatric care is one of the important care which we have to give. Often we misinterpret their character in their old age. For an example, even I can tell about my own mother. My mother, who is an 89-year-old, is living with me. I couldn't find anything with her, but when my younger sister came from US, she found and she told me, "Mummy is behaving something else." I said, "No, I can't find anything wrong in that. She is like everyone like." Then she took her to the neurologist, and when the doctor asked her, my sister, who is she? She told the doctor, "She is my uncle's daughter." My younger sister started crying there. She came home and she said, "Mummy needs medical attention." So she took for scanning and we found she was suffering with senile dementia. Many of us, after that only, I came across, I'm living in an apartment. In apartment you find many elders, both husband and wife couple staying alone. They lock the door inside. So I started speaking to them. All otherwise I usually go for work, come back, that was my routine. So in the evening time, when they go for a stroll inside the apartment, I used to go and talk to them and they used to complain. So she is forgetting this. She uncle is forgetting that uncle is gone somewhere. And they'll come and tell me, "Why don't you come go and search for uncle?" So it's a small community. We only 56 houses are there. And the way I take care of my mother, it was fascinating for them. They say, "I love you, we all love you. We want a daughter like you." Why I am saying is, as sir was telling, whenever my mother used to be so adamant with whatever she wanted, she'll say, "I want to go to church." Then I'll tell her, "Mommy, this is not, though it is a Sunday, I'll tell her, "Mommy, this is not Sunday. Tomorrow is the Sunday, we'll go home. We'll go to church." Then she'll be calmed down. So, now I have taught my maid also to behave like that. That is why being a spinster, I'm taking care of my mother with a, with a thankful heart, I say it to my servant. So she also learned the tricks how to keep my mother. I'm standing before you all because I know my maid will take care of my mother so well. So as we go into this geriatric care, dementia, Parkinson's and Alzheimer's disease are the most common one. Though they look normal, they'll have all these conditions before. In 1999, I was a student, MSc student, so they posted, they sent us 1 week to Bombay, SNDT University, for an educational tour. So on the way, from every morning when we were going around the city, we saw many old people getting together in a park and they were all laughing. In a round, men and women, they were standing and laughing. So we laughed at them. We said, "Oh, they are old people. They don't have any other work. They are start laughing and going." So that time we never had any idea what it is and why they are doing it. As days gone by, I was searching this. It was got into my mind and I thought I should know about this. When I started seeking this, and there was lot of things were available on laughter therapy. So laughter therapy is nothing but laughter or smiling or a humor which you were coming across. Whenever you enter a home, you want the first person who is seeing you to smile at you. Isn't it not? Yes? If your mommy or daddy is having a big face, you will run and hide in your room. If mommy is smiling at you, you also will go and talk to her and telling her everything. Or your friend, the way she looks or the smile she gives will make you very happy. Isn't it? Even for no reason of something, you all will giggle, you all will laugh in the hostel room. Yes or no? If your friend is crying in your room, or if you see her not writing her assignment after the exam, if she cries out and coming, you all try to make her laugh. Isn't it? You don't sit and cry with her, but you will make her to laugh. Why are you doing that? Just to relax her mind or relax her self. So now we are going to see. So I thought, why don't I use this laughter therapy in a geriatric care setup? The urbanization has taken up, globalization also is more. You all know, from morning they were talking about from joint family, they have come to a nuclear family. Earlier, 7 children very happy, 9 children very happy. If the more the children are, the parents are praised for. Then came a period, the government started saying, we two, ours two. Then came, we two, ours one. Now it is saying, we two, why one? Is it not? So the family also is shrinking, the old geriatric patient or old age people are growing up. The another one very important trend now, what it is, when they become older, they are tend to go and get themselves admitted to an old age home, institutionalized setting. They feel very comfortable. Now, because of the technology improvement, they are very happy to go and settle. In Coimbatore, where I live, the fact which has come out is, gated communities only for the old age people. So they have flat, they have individual houses even for crores of rupees in one setup. So the one which I went is Ananya's Nana Nani home, which is nearby to my house. So when I went inside, it was just like an, what to say, heaven. So everywhere lights were there. At around 7 p.m. I went to meet someone over there. So I found the elders are very happy, some bhajans are going on, some are eating, some are watching movies. It is like they have cinema theatres and everything. So when I asked that aunt, the aunt whom I went to meet is, she had only daughter and she was settled in US. Now they are 70 plus and they don't have anybody to take care. So they all come and live in an apartment and there are 450 houses are there. Once the construction start building, it's all filled up. So fast it built up. And medical personnel are posted over there. There are a lot of nurses are there. Lot of doctors are there. They are given a quarters inside to take care of them. So this is the newer trend which are coming. So though we talk about the geriatric health, though they are healthy, they physically and psychologically, they suffer a lot. As madam was talking about spirituality, in this setup, the spirituality is more on high. And they take tours on temples and other things. Or Christians, they go for churches. Hindus go for temples. So far, I haven't come across any Muslims staying in that way. But these two groups were more into that. So I thought, why don't I use this laughter therapy in an institutionalized setting? Usually, they lack two things. One is quality of life. The other one is quality of sleep. Quality of life and quality of sleep. Quality of life, as we know, physically, psychologically, socially, they are downward because they are not cope up with the demand of it. But whereas in quality of sleep, so in case of dementia, Alzheimer's, they are not aware of the timings. So they say even in the morning they'll sleep, night they'll get up, brush their teeth and sit over it. So these two has to be come to be minimized. So I thought I'll use this laughter therapy. So before that I wanted to tell you what is laugh. So laugh, how many of you laugh today? Can you raise up your hand? Maybe only when you come here and sir said something, we all laughed. Other than that, maybe by seeing WhatsApp, some jokes, you might laugh by yourself, isn't it? So it says, a child laughed at 150 to 400 times per day. When a newborn baby smiles, we often say, oh, baby is seeing one angel, that's why he is smiling. At the same time, when an adult keeps laughing, they say, see, he laugh like a devil. Yes. So, whereas an average adult laughs only for 15 to 20 times a day. This laugh means not a louder laugh, but it can be a smile, a giggle, or different types. So let me tell you what are the types of laughter and what are the things we have to do. Here they say, a chuckle a day keeps the doctor away. You now know the famous proverb, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. But now, a chuckle a day keeps the doctor away. There is nothing in the world so irresistibly contagious as laughter and good humor. Even when your friend laughs, even without knowing the reason, if you enter into the group, you tend to laugh. Isn't it? After laughing, you laugh, why did you laugh? Isn't it? Why did you laugh? Yeah. So that is the stunt. So what are the facts about the laughter? We all know, first thing it says, there are 8 things you didn't know about the laughter. One good belly laugh burns about 35 calories. If you want to reduce your weight, no need to go for an exercise, you can laugh. So most people can't laugh on command. If you tell people in a military post and say, laugh, no one will laugh, isn't it? It has to come by nature. And the sound of laughter isn't associated with any one language, isn't it? So no language is there. You can keep laughing. You try to laugh 100 to 400 times a day. That's about 2,800 times a week and 1,46,000 year. Laughter is the best medicine what you can go upon. So coming to the structure of laughter, what is laughter? Say, laughing is not a random vocal sound, but it is characterized by a series of start vowels like note. Each note is about 75 milliseconds long and repeated at regular intervals about 200 million seconds apart. So what does it mean? For other sound, if you want to tame an animal, it's a cack, isn't it? But whereas if you want to laugh, it comes, you don't control your vocal, it comes out spontaneously. That is what it means. What is laughter therapy? So laughter is an aerobic humor and internal jogging for all the major organs. If you laugh very loudly, you can find your belly is also laughing along with that. Is it not? Yes. Sometimes you will bend and laugh like that, isn't it? When all of you are sitting and laughing, you will do that. That's what it says. Laughter therapy is a unique idea where anyone can laugh for no reason to promote laughter as a cure for physical, psychological and spiritual ailments. So, when your friend is crying that she didn't meet her boyfriend, if you say some joke, she will forget all those things. She will laugh and she will talk and she will calm down. Otherwise, the situation in that place makes you so not acceptable one, isn't it? So everyone will be moody inside the room and no one will love that. That definition is given by Madan Kataria, who is the founder of laughter therapy, and he is very famous personality in Bombay and also in India. Laughter therapy is known as a psychotherapeutic technique or strategy intended to produce mental and emotional benefits through laughter. So laughter is very important in our life. So any situation you laugh. History of laughter therapy. In his book, The Expression of the Emotions in Man and Animals, Charles Darwin speculated that the evolutionary basis of laughter was its function as a social expression of happiness, and that this gave a cohesive survival advantage of the group. So, what is it says, when you want to have a very happy social living, you need to have it. So if you keep walking but without seeing your neighbors or anyone, it doesn't help you. You're emotionally, you will drain out, and also physically, you will not be able to come out of it. Then the laughter in humans evolved some 5 to 7 million years ago, even prior to the evolution of human language. Laughter therapy started when human ancestors started walking in two legs. Even if you see many English movies, those are based on monkeys only. With the monkeys, they show a lot of movies which will be very funny enough to watch. Then Martin traced a notation from Bible in the song, "A merry heart doeth good like a medicine." Then Hazard noted that in 17th century, the arrival of a good clown exercise more beneficial influence than that of a 20 asses laden with the drugs. Even if you go to a circus, you find many clowns. You know why they have put the clowns? You will get bored by watching the animals and the men playing the game. But if you see a clown coming in between, you will tend to laugh. There is one more clown therapy is there that is used in pediatric ward. Have you heard about it? Clown therapy, where these dwarfs or even you can make yourself as a clown and go into the pediatric ward where the children can be very happy with the, they all will be sitting and crying, isn't it? And their drugs, when the IV is going or injection is being given, they will be very scared. But if we give this clown therapy, that is very much useful for the babies, the children. That. Coming to that, laughter therapy was made popular and practiced as routine exercise by Indian physicians. But sadly, no Indian are following it up. If you go abroad, many are following these things. So these laughter clubs are available in IT department, police department, but and school teachers, even school children, before their exams, this laughter therapy is used in many places. First laughter yoga club began in 13th March 1995 in Mumbai, beginning with 5 people in a local public park. Then only I understood what I saw was a laughter club. Current scenario shows more than 8,000 laughter clubs in 65 countries. There are, what is the physiology of laughter therapy? Laughter can lead to direct physiological effect on overall body system. And laughter can lead to more positive emotional status. And laughter can optimize one's own strategy for coping with stress and strengthen personal pain tolerance. Then laughter may indirectly increase social competencies and may increase the interpersonal relationship. Even when you talk to each other, you will tell, she didn't even smile, she didn't even laugh, isn't it? That is the term what we use. So if you smile, everything is over, isn't it? So you keep a smile when you see anyone. Then coming to this pathophysiology, as we nurses say, what is the laughter pathophysiology? When you give a first seconds of laughter, there are 50 facial muscles contracts and releases. So instead of you using a chewing gum to improve your facial muscle thing, you can use laughter. This will be better than the chewing gum. Laughter, it increases catecholamine levels, which influences the interpersonal responsiveness, alertness and memory. Laughter increases release of endorphins, which are natural opiates to decrease pain. Laughter decreases serum cortisol level, that is the stress hormone. Laughter, it has a punctuation effect. Laughter boosts the antibody producing cells, enhances T cells and stronger immune system. So this is very important, because the geriatric patients or senior citizens are more prone to get less immunity. So if you give them these exercises, this will be very much useful. There are two therapies are there, humor and laughter therapy. Let us see what is the meaning of humor and what is the meaning of laughter. Humor is defined as one of the stimuli that can help people laugh and feel happy. Laughter is defined as psychopathological response to humor or any other stimuli. If you sit and watch a movie where there are comedy tracks are there, you just sit and smile yourself, so that can be called humor. Humor is sense. But when you sit together and see this, and one laughter can become a contagious laughter and becomes a laughter. So humor is perceptual process, but laughter is a behavioral process. Yes, is it true? Laughter, you cannot openly laugh when your vice chairman is there, isn't it? But at the same time, when your friend is there, you can laugh aloud, isn't it? So it has certain behavioral traits in it with the laughter. Humor, you can laugh and say, she is like that only, isn't it? So these are the things. Humor is an intellectual capacity to perceive something funny, and laughter is a physical reaction to a stimuli. Humor is a stimulus and can occur without laughter, but laughter is a response and can occur without humor. What are the different types of laughter? I think if you are very good in English, you will understand all these terms which is used into. Chuckle. What is chuckle? Just you smile and go away. That is chuckle. What is chuckle? That means when you are watching a funny movie or something, you will keep laughing. Giggle. Giggling is like lesser laughter. Laughter will have a louder voice, but giggle will have a lesser voice and go away. Snicker. Snicker means like that, isn't it? Inside. It's a all positive one. Sorry, negative response of a thing which you show with the higher official, that snicker. Cackle, what is that thing? When you hear somebody is laughing in the next room or something, you also laugh here in your room, listening to them. And snicker, it is when you have somebody makes a mistake, you make fun of it and laughing into it. Then be rolling on the floor, this you will see in your kids at home. When they watch Tom and Jerry alone in the hall, you can see them rolling around and laughing without knowing the reason, isn't it? That is, these are the different types of laughter. The next is the types of laughter. What are the, there are lot of types of laughter are available, which only certain things alone we can use in the senior citizen. In geriatric health setup, we can use these things. One is the belly laugh, explosive laughter, pigeon laughter, nervous laughter, contagious laughter, snorting laughter, etiquette laughter, silent laughter, cruel laughter. By itself, you all know the meaning of it. So now let me see one by one. What is belly laughter? I'll tell you the procedure wise and tell you. It breaks out naturally when we find something truly hilarious. It could be a joke or situation that can leave us rolling on the floor, clutching our belly and gasping for air. This is the highest form of laughing, isn't it? When you laugh, when you are seeing, after a tour, when you come back in the room, sitting and reminiscing the things what you have done, you will say, oh, she went inside, she did this one, she did that one, and keep laughing together, isn't it? So that means, if you have a belly, it really will dance with you when you do a laughter. That is only is called belly laughter. Next one is explosive laughter. What do you mean by this explosive laughter? You cannot keep it inside. Even your BC is there, you will burst out into laughter. So that is only is called explosive laughter. And third one is pigeon laughter. You know how the pigeon will give, make sound? So within yourself, you will be laughing into it. That is called pigeon laughter. And next is nervous laughter. When you when you meet your guide or somebody, you will be nervous, but she will be telling a joke. You will be thinking whether to laugh, whether not to laugh, but you want to laugh. So that is the situation where you find this nervous laughter. Next one is contagious laughter that I told you already. When one person laughs, it spread to all the people, isn't it? So that is called contagious laughter. And next is snorting laughter. It is like when you laugh, you will be stopping laughing. It will be a continuous one. Then etiquette laughter. When you wanted to laugh, you keep your legs. When Queen Elizabeth comes and tells you something, you wanted to laugh, but you cannot. You laugh like this, within yourself. So that is only called etiquette laughter. If you laugh louder, they will send you out of the place. So that is called etiquette laughter. Then silent laughter. Silent laughter is when in a place where you cannot laugh very loudly, you will be listening to the joke and laugh very silently. For an example, when a sermon, when our priest is telling some joke, we cannot laugh very loudly in the church, isn't it? So your behavior tend to make you to laugh lesser. So that is what we call silent laughter. Then this is called cruel laughter. Cruel laughter, you all might have seen in the movies, isn't it? The villain put the leg on the hero and he will laugh, isn't it? So that laugh only is called villain laughter. Then you have very, I'll show you the laughter, how it has been done, the therapy in the geriatric setup. There are various laughter programs are there. One is humor therapy, second is laughter therapy, third is laughter meditation, and fourth one is laughter clubs. Humor therapy, that when you are sitting alone and watching some, not only the movie, or when you are sitting and thinking about the reminiscing about your good golden days, and with your friends, whatever it comes in your mind, that you can take it yourself. Laughter therapy, that when you, before your principal will give you, before going for an exam, 9 o'clock when you enter, she will all call you, 9:45 come, we'll have a good laugh to relax yourself before entering into your thing. So that is called laughter therapy. Many studies have been done in many setups to know the result into. Laughter meditation, this is being alone. When you are alone, how you will meditate. Same way you think about your olden good days with your laughter and do that. Laughter clubs in your society or in your locality, you can bring your friends and neighbors, or else in your apartment, or else in your school, or else when you go for a play in the morning with your friends, you do. That is called laughter clubs, or these are the four laughter programs available. What is smile? What does it mean, smile? Whether smile and laughter are same? No. Smile, it is the following aspect which made the laughter therapy program. It is a stress management technique. M is for mindfulness practices. I is for imagination and imagery. And L is for laughter and lifestyle. And E is for exercise and energy. If you smile and laugh, you will lose many calories. You relax your mind, you will become fit enough physically and mentally. Then what are the creating opportunities to love? These are some of the things. One is to watch a funny movie or a TV show. Nobody wants to go home sitting and watching some movies which shows the very bad things, isn't it? So if you want to go, you wanted to watch a very nice family movies or else a funny movie, English funny movie, Mr. Bean or Mask, like that. A movie you wanted to watch because you can relax your mind. Second is getting into a comedy club or read the funny pages, seek out funny people. These funny pages, we know when you take a magazine, weekly magazine, what you buy, the first thing what you do is you read all the jokes first, isn't it not? You don't read the stories or other thing, read all the jokes first, then only you will go page by page. Then seeking out the funny people, if your friend is very humorous, you tell, you will go to her place and whatever you say, she will say something to make you laugh. So those kind of people, you tend to go and meet them and share a good joke or a funny story. Nowadays, you see people in the bus with their earphone and around seeing movie, they'll be laughing. And other people might think, oh, they are mad. No, but they are watching, they are reading a joke or something from the WhatsApp group and they are laughing by themselves. And check out at bookstore's humor section. Host a game night with friends, play with the pet, go to a laughter yoga class, goof around with children, do something silly, make time for funny activities. Funny activities with children and other things. Three times you all say, aha, oh ho ho. You have to laugh. Okay, turn it to each other. Aha, oh ho ho. Aha, oh ho ho. Aha, oh ho ho. Thank you so much. I think.